So let me introduce myself first. So my name is Rishabh Raj and I am from India. Currently I am working as a junior developer intern at Botas Automation Private Limited Company. I mostly love to work with React and Python. I also write articles. So if you want to know more about me, you can visit my website. So today's content is all about the open source. So firstly, we see the introduction of open source software. And then we see the open source software philosophy. Then after, we see why we use of open source software. Then the most interesting part of this session is come that plan your next weekend using open source software. And the last, we see the list of all open source, best open source software, alternative for paid software. So let's start with the first slide. So open source software, what is open source software? When a developer creates and releases its source code publicly with a license so that anyone can see or add modify some functionality, that's when software is termed as open. So basically, when any software developed by any software developer, and then they share their software source code in public with the license, so and the public have access to see the source code and also have a power to contribute to that software, means they can modify the software source code, they can add more functionality to improve the performance of software, and even they can fix the software bugs, means they even fix the part of that software that does not work properly. Software means it gives extra power to all of us. So we can contribute to the open source any software for according to us. Means you can also fix the bugs, you can also add and remove some functionality. So I mean, especially they give a power to contributors who contribute to open source software. So basically that is open source software. Then software termed as open source software. Go to next slide. So open source software philosophy. Open source was introduced in the 90s. But the software industry was skeptical about the whole process. However, two decades later, the some companies use open source for their product or develop their own open source software. So basically, open source software is nowadays open source are so popular, and those companies who were worried about the process of open source, means they worried about the source, the process, the whole the process of open source, that how we can share the public source code to publicly in 90s, but then after two decades now, which those companies are also used the open source in their product, even they develop the open source software. So even the software contribution, even open source contribution also helps to grow the country GDP. Just take example of UK. According to some organization, that the open source contribution to the contribution to open source is 42 billion in UK GDP. That grow UK GDP. So you see, and that makes it fifth largest globally open source contributor. So here you see how open source popular nowadays. See why we use open source software over paid alternative. Imagine you bought a new mobile phone and Google start charging you for the Android. it sounds scary, but there is many other paid software in the market that charge money for same functionality that open source software gives us free. Basically, imagine you bought a new mobile phone and Google suddenly started charging for using Android. How you feel? It really feels scary. Means if we have to spend the money for mobile phone, and even you have to pay the money for Android also. So it's scary. It feels so scary, but presently not real. Google not taking charge for using Android, but the just like that, the same some company who asking for take a charge, means they take a charge for same functionality that open source software gives us to free. That's like if you there are so many companies who take charge money for the same function that open source software gives us to free. So why we use that software? Why not we use open source alternative to save our money? That is a major reason to use open source alternative over paid software application to save our money. So basically, open source known for security, affordability, transparency, interoperability, and flexibility. Basically, open source provides so many advantages to the user. I mean, they give so many advantages. Let's take an example of me or you. Imagine you want to develop a software, but you cannot afford to do it. So, okay, wait, am I audible now? Okay. So, yeah, so imagine. Okay, thank you. Okay. So, imagine, take an example of your, if you have to develop a software, but you cannot afford to do it. Just like you cannot afford to do it, you have not much time, you have not expertise, not much money to invest. Just like me, I am a college student. I don't have much time. I have so many work to do. Like I have a college assignment, even lab work, even to maintain the attendance of my college 75%. So we have not much time, and I also don't have much industry experience. So just like any specialization. And not as much money to invest to my software. So in this situation, we can take a help of open source software. So we can take a help of open source software that is related to our project. Just like if you want to create a messaging app, so we can take a help of Signal. They have the open source. So we can take a help of Signal. We can see the source code. We can take a help of Signal. So basically, when we take a help of another software source code and start developing our software and customize according to us what we need and customize according to us and what your from your need, so that it make it more flexible, means software more flexible. You don't need to spend so much money, don't need much tech time from starting from scratch. You just take another help of another open source software and start taking the help of open source and start developing your own software. So how open source software is, how the advantage of open source software is, see, it is more security and affordability, transparency, interoperability, and flexibility. It gives more flexibility to user. So look at this example. Yeah, Linux. This is the open source operating system. So basically, you see that there are different versions of open source Linux. Like we use Kali Linux, we have Ubuntu, we have Parrot, but they all are based on the main source of Linux. So how you see from a one source code to another, from the help taking the help of another one source code, we can create another software develop another software. So here you see. Okay, we can see again another open source software is React. React is a front-end library. they're developed by Facebook. It is very useful for front-end developers. So many front-end developers use React. And so it is very flexible to use. It helps us to create so a small component to make a big website. So it makes easy to create a website. So just like that. So it gives more advantage, just like the creating website. So another is Android. So we all know about Android. We all used once the time in our life that using Android. So we know about Android. Android is a mobile operating system. So into next slide. So there line open source works with quantity to create superior quality of software. So I think you get this line means open source work with quantity. So many developer and contributor comes to the contribute to one of software and to make the software performance great. So see how the quantity comes to create a superior quality of software. So going to next slide. So the most interesting part of this event, plan your next weekend. So you can plan your next weekend by using open source software. Maybe it sounds funny, but if you use open source software instead of paying the for paid software, you will save money. Of course, we see previously that when we see how other paid applications take charge for us for using same functionality that open source gives us free. So using open source instead of paid application, we save money. And if we save money, you can enjoy weekend. But we all love weekends. We can plan our next weekend using open source. Let's begin with next slide. So now come with the list of open source software that we can use for personal or professional use. So if before going to the list of all open source, so I ask from you all, so anyone use any open source means from now, if you all know about any open source software, so can please write in chat Okay, so wait for the reply. So first we see the first open source software is Doggy. Doggy is an open source software powered by Gatsby that helps in creating or maintaining documents in just few steps, and you will be ready with your documents. Okay, so it's never been easier to document your things. The definition of DocG is really it works like the definition means if you develop a software or when you develop a software, the documentation takes a major role of in development of software, because if you don't create document if your software. It's just like selling the dress without price tag. Means audience don't get what the software is, what is how to use software if you don't guide them. So for creating the documentation is very very important for any development and any project. So for that, Doggy help us to creating our documents very easily. Now creating document using Doggy is just a piece of cake. So you can start using Doggy in just few steps. You don't need to write so many commands to install Doggy in your PC or your system. You just need to one or two steps and you can start using Doggy. Easy to customize. You can customize your theme. You can customize different themes for your documentation. It is also powered by Gatsby. Means performance of Doggy is very good. and it is based on MDX. So you can use the MDX format to create your document. You can take a help of MDX format and to create the documentation. For more information on DocG, you can visit the official site of DocG, www.docg.site. I will share in the end of this event a link of, okay, don't worry about that. So the next software, open source software, is TypeSense. So let's see what their definition says. Lightning fast open source search, no PhD required. Okay. So the TypeSense is an open source search engine that gives you the most accurate result even after spelling mistake or typos. It is simple to use, an open source alternative for Agile, Azolia and Elasticsearch. So yeah, TypeSense is different from any other search engine, and because it gives you accurate result even your spelling mistake. You don't need to worry about your spelling mistake. You can write without worry about your spelling mistake. So but TypeSense can make your spelling mistake right and give an accurate result. Even the TypeSense have so amazing features, like you can filter your results. Means you can filter your results according to your search. You can pin your results. You can also pin your results. So it makes different from any other search engine. So it is so lightweight. So don't worry to use in your application. You can, without worry about your application performance, you can use TypeSense in your application without any worry. So for get more information about TypeSense, you can visit their official website, typesense.org. Now the next is Mobile Security Framework. So the Mobile Security Framework is automated all-in-one mobile application. Pen testing, malware analysis, and security assessment framework capable of performing static and dynamic analysis. So all you hear about the cyber attacks. Yeah, okay. So all you hear about cyber attacks. I just ask you from all you, anyone hear about cyber attacks? Don't worry about the chat. I will solve all your query in few minutes. Don't worry about. So don't worry. So I hope you all hear about cyber attack. So cyber attack is when the hacker attack your personal or professional device and steal all your data. Means someone hacker attack your device and steal your data, and they can use your data as a criminal as for any crime. But so it is very dangerous because your data is very personal, they can use for any crime. But MO Mobile Security Framework help keep our all data secure. It is open source tool. Open source tool for all application. Means you can use for Android, iOS, and even Windows 4. And it automate the analysis of APK. Means you automate your APK analysis of your APK. And you can also install in multiple devices. Like I said, you can use in Android also, iOS, and Windows. So it is very good tool for our data securing through data. You may go to their official website to know more about that. Their website is mobsf.github.io. Yeah, Chatwood, of course. So, Chatwood is an open source software that integrates with all your social media platforms in a single dashboard, so that you can connect with your customer in one place. So, as any as a part of any organization or any startup, and you are a social media manager of any company, we all have to handle all social media and reply of all messages on every social media to audience. But it is not possible to giving. It is not possible to check out all social media in one time, or we have not much time to check out all social media at the same time. So we can miss some messages, and we can miss some messages that make bad impact to our audience. If you founding a startup and if you make bad impact on audience, that's not good for us, not good for them. So Chatwood is an open source software who come with the solution for this. Means you don't need to go for all social media one by one. You can check all the social media messages in one dashboard. Yeah, right. You can see all the social media messages in one dashboard. That would give you a power to see this. So you can see all single dashboard. Well, sometimes you can, and that makes you more sense that you can see all the messages in one dashboard. So don't have chance to miss some social media. Don't forget to check out another social media. You can all connect your social media in a single dashboard and you can check. So that make more sense to use Chatwood. And after that, you can also add the Chatwood to your website or your application, like lab chats. So you can automate your live chat in your application in Chatwood. So, and the last, and there's another feature in Chatwood is chatbots. So sometimes the audience have so simple queries, means they just want to ask for the working hours to your office. So visiting. So we have so many, not much time to see, and sometimes we miss even after the single dashboard. Sometimes we even miss that, or even audience not wait, have not much patience to wait for the reply of us. They want suddenly, they eventually want eventually reply. So for that, the chatbot gives the future chatbot. So you can enable your bot chatbots. So to giving some, like if you send some messages and chatbot give a reply or some question, like simple question, like audience public asks from your working out, the chatbot suddenly immediately gives the reply to audience that working hour is this. So that makes more impression to our audience. So yeah, you can visit their official website to know more about chatbot. The website is www.chatwood.com. So now, one of my favorite open source software, and I most use this software. So let's see, the Hopscotch. It is an open source software API development ecosystem. It make easy to work with API development. It simplifies creating, using, and testing APIs with a beautiful user interface. So I think every developer's best friend. Working with API is just like eating food every day. I mean, if you are a developer and you know how important is API, means API is just like eating your food every day. Working with API is just like eating your food every day. It is very necessary for every developer. So, but working with API is not much. From just few years ago, working with API is just not like easy. Means working with API is just like rubbing a stone to set a fire, just like that. You need to command line to work with API. It takes long time to testing your API. So, but now presently Hopscotch help creates the solution, make a solution for that, and it creates a such type of ecosystem. API development with a great UI interface means you have not one, you can create easily, you can easily test your API, you can perform CRUD operation easily, you can create, edit, all can you can do it one single place with a great UI, with great UI. So it is very useful for every developer to testing your API. Does not like rubbing a stone to set a fire. So I of course advise you to please check out this software, HubSpot. Their official website is hubspot.io. So let me